Hans Christian Oersted, a Danish scientist, had discovered that when a conductor carries current, it produces a magnetic field around it. And we have studied about the properties of the magnetic field that a current carrying conductor produces around it. Now, as you can see in the picture, the current carrying wires have a certain magnetic field around them, which has been depicted by the magnetic field lines. Now, the direction of the magnetic field lines can be obtained with the help of the right-hand thumb rule, as you will recall. Now, let us see an interesting video in order to find out the behavior of this current carrying wire in the presence of another magnetic field. In this video, you will find that a wire has been placed in between the poles of another magnet. Now, this magnet, as you can see, is a horseshoe-shaped magnet, and it is an external magnet. So we can say that this magnet has been kept and a wire has been kept in between its poles. Now notice what happens when we allow current to flow through the wire. The moment current will flow through this wire, it will have a magnetic field around it, which the current will generate. Now there will be a certain behavior of the wire in the presence of the external magnetic field. As you can see, there is some sort of an invisible force that is acting on the wire, causing it to get displaced from its original position. You will find if we reverse the direction of current, the direction of force is also reversed. So initially we found that it got deflected to the left hand side, now it gets deflected to the right hand side. So where is this force coming from? Let us try to explain it with the concepts of physics and magnetic field lines. So initially, when we had simply kept the wire in between the poles of this magnet, we found that there was no force that acted on the conductor. Why? Because initially we had considered no current is flowing through the conductor. Now let us see what happens when current starts flowing through the conductor. As you can see, the moment current starts flowing, indicated by the highlighted wires, there is a force that acts on the conductor, causing it to get deflected to the left hand side. A similar thing happens if we reverse the direction of current, but in the opposite direction. So over here, we have reversed the direction of current, and as we can see, the force is now acting on the conductor in the opposite direction. So initially, the force acting on the conductor took it inwards or inside the magnet. Now the force acting on the conductor is bringing it outside the magnet. So now let us try to explain with the help of magnetic field lines how this force is exactly acting on the conductor. Firstly, we consider the magnet. Now this magnet will obviously have magnetic field lines which will be moving from north to south. So as you can see, I have marked out the magnetic field lines from north to south. In a similar manner, if we consider the current carrying conductor, it will also have a magnetic field around it given by the right-hand thumb rule. So over here, as you can see, the direction of current is in this manner, all through the wire and back to the battery. So if I apply the right-hand thumb rule, my thumb will indicate the direction of current, that is this direction, and my fingers encircling the wire or the conductor will give me the direction of magnetic field lines. So with the help of blue arrows, I have marked out the direction of magnetic field lines. So we find that the current carrying conductor creates a magnetic field around it. Now notice what happens when the current carrying conductor is kept in between the poles of the magnet. Under such a situation, the two magnetic fields, one of the external magnet and one of the current carrying conductor, interact with one another. Now you will notice that at this particular point, the two fields are in the same direction. That is the field due to the external magnet as well as due to the current carrying conductor. And at this point, they are in opposite direction. So when the field lines are in the same direction, it means there is the presence of an excess amount of force than the case where the field lines are in opposite directions. At that point, the force cancel out one another. Or in other words, the force due to the external magnet cancels out the one due to the current carrying conductor. So this means that there is an addition of field due to co-directional magnetic lines on this particular side, and there is a cancellation of field due to opposite direction lines on this particular side. So this means the force that will act on the wire will be from this point to this point. As you can see that due to the current carrying wire, the magnetic field of the permanent magnet or the external magnet have been stretched like a rubber band. And it is due to this stretching that there is an interaction taking place between both the magnetic fields. And this interaction is causing the force to act from this side to this side. Because over here, the field lines are co-directional, whereas on this particular side, they are in the opposite direction. Now, if the current carrying conductor is placed parallel to the external magnetic field, no force will act on it. In the previous case, we saw that if this was the magnetic field from north to south, the current carrying conductor was placed perpendicular to the external magnetic field. However, if the current carrying conductor is placed parallel to the magnetic field, then no force will act on the conductor. Why? Because in the previous case, where the two were perpendicular, in that case, there was a scope for the addition of magnetic field and the cancellation of magnetic field because they were in the same plane. Or in other words, there was a time when they were in the same direction and in the opposite direction. But if this wire is kept parallel, then you will find that the magnetic field generated around the wire will not be in the same plane as that of the external magnetic field. So this will imply that there is no scope for addition, neither cancellation. So it is due to this reason that there will be no interaction between the two magnetic fields, and thus no force will act on the wire. So this means that there will be no displacement of the conductor if the conductor is placed parallel to the external magnetic field. It has also been experimentally found out that the displacement of the conductor is maximum, or the magnitude of the force is highest, when the direction of current is at right angles to the direction of magnetic field. Or in other words, if the current carrying conductor and the external magnetic field are placed at right angles or perpendicular to one another, under that situation, the force is maximum because the interaction between these two fields will be the maximum. So this leads us to a very important rule known as Fleming's left-hand rule. Now the scientist Fleming had given this rule in order to find out in which direction the force will act. As you saw in the previous cases, certain elaborate experiments were carried out in order to determine in which direction the force acts. With the help of this simple rule, we can also find out the direction in which force acts. And we do not need to carry out any elaborate experiments. So let us say we have the magnetic field in this particular direction and we place our index finger pointing towards that direction. We place our middle finger pointing in a direction at which current is flowing. And if we place the thumb perpendicular to both the index finger as well as the middle finger, we will find that the direction of the thumb gives us the direction of force acting on the conductor. So if I place my fingers in this manner, with the index finger denoting magnetic field direction and middle finger denoting the current direction, then the thumb will denote the direction of force. So as you can see, firstly we have to stretch the forefinger, middle finger and thumb of the left hand in this manner such that they are perpendicular to one another. In that situation, if the forefinger points in the direction of magnetic field and the middle finger points in the direction of current, then the thumb will give us the direction of force. So let us demonstrate this rule. Over here, we can see that current is flowing in this manner all the way through and back to the battery. So now let us apply Fleming's left-hand rule in order to demonstrate whether the force is indeed proper. So over here, current, which is the middle finger, flows in this direction and the magnetic field is from bottom to top. So this gives us the thumb pointing inwards. So as you can see, the conductor is getting displaced inwards. Similarly, in this case, current is flowing in the opposite direction, or as you can see, from here to here. So I place the index finger in the same manner. Why? Because the direction of magnetic field does not change. And I place my middle finger in the direction of current that has reversed and is from this end to this end. So now if I stretch out my thumb, I will find that the thumb is stretched out in the outward direction. And as you can see, the direction of displacement of this particular conductor is also in the outward direction. Thus, we found out that Fleming's left hand rule gives us the direction of force acting on the current carrying conductor very easily.